Hello students, good morning. As I said in my last class, that today I am going to discuss the different kinds of induction. That means the classification of induction. So before you start, look at the chart of the classification of induction. What it is? Induction has classified mainly into two kinds, and it is Mill who has classified induction mainly into two kinds. Is that? Induction proper and induction improperly so called. Then again, induction proper has classified into scientific induction, unscientific induction and analogy, and induction improperly so called has classified into perfect induction, induction by parity of reasoning and colligation of facts. So let us start one by one. First classification of induction, which is done by Mill, is that the induction has been classified broadly into induction proper and induction improperly so called. Now, you know what is induction? Induction is the mental process in which we pass from something known to something unknown. Then it has two groups, induction proper and induction improperly so called. What is induction proper? Induction proper is a kind of induction where exists an inductive leap. In induction proper, on the basis of direct observation of or experiment on particular instances, a universal conclusion is proved and established in the conclusion. That means induction proper is a kind of induction where exists an inductive leap. In induction proper, on the basis of direct observation, what we do? We establish a universal conclusion, and while establishing the universal conclusion, the observed cases through which we establish the universal conclusion . In this, there exists a inductive leap or hazard of induction. So, simply speaking, induction proper is that kind of induction in which when we pass from something known to unknown, something observed to unobserved, there remains an inductive leap and which is very much necessary, because inductive leap is the essence of induction. So, induction proper is that kind of induction in which inductive leap is very much present. And between the premises and the conclusion, there is an inductive leap or hazard of induction, and this is the characteristics of induction proper. Now, induction proper may be of three kinds: scientific induction, unscientific induction, and analogy. That means, as scientific induction, unscientific induction, and analogy, all these three belongs to the group of induction proper. That means, in all these three kinds of induction, the inductive leap or hazard is very much present. Now, let us see one by one what are they. That means, what is scientific induction, what are its characteristics, what is unscientific induction, its characteristics, and analogy. Now, let us start. What is scientific induction? Scientific induction is the establishment of a general real proposition in reliance on the principle of the uniformity of nature and the law of causation. So, this is the very definition of scientific induction. Let us explain one by one. Scientific induction is the establishment of a general real proposition. For example, all men are mortal, and how do we get it? Through particular instances. That means, say Ram is mortal, Shyam is mortal, Jadu is mortal, Madhu is mortal, etc., etc. Therefore, here we are jumping from particular cases to general with the help of inductive leap, that all men are mortal. So, here we are establishing a general real proposition. So, scientific induction is the establishment of a general real proposition. Fine. Then question is, how do you know after perceiving some cases that all men are mortal? How do you know? Then our answer is, with the help of two fundamental principle, we are establishing all men are mortal. How and what are these two fundamental principles? These two principles are law of causation and uniformity of nature. Law of causation says that every event must have a cause. So, when you are establishing a conclusion, general conclusion, that all men are mortal, here man and mortality, these two are causally related. Humanity and mortality, they are causally related. Causal relation is there between them. And so man and mortality, there is a causal relation, and our law of uniformity of nature says that same thing will produce same effect under similar circumstances. So, if there is a causal relation between man and mortality, so it will be present in all cases of man and mortality. So, by definition, what it is? That scientific induction is the establishment of a general real proposition, okay, based on observation of particular instances. Means you have perceived some cases and then you are generalizing all men are mortal. In reliance on the principle of the uniformity of nature and the law of causation, as I have said. How do you know all men are mortal? With the help of two principles, uniformity of nature and law of causation, because there is a causal relation between humanity and mortality, and according to law of uniformity of nature, same thing will produce same effect under similar circumstances. That means in all cases there will be a causal relation between humanity and mortality. So, this is the definition of scientific induction. Now, let us define the characteristics or marks of scientific induction. What are they? Firstly, scientific induction establishes a general real proposition. I repeat, scientific induction always establishes a general real proposition. You know what is general proposition is? General proposition is one in which the predicate is affirmed or denied of an indefinite number of individuals. All men. It includes indefinite number of individuals. Predicate is affirming. So, this is general proposition. Scientific induction establishes. Again, scientific induction establishes not only the general proposition, real proposition also. What is real proposition? This also you know. We know that there are two types of proposition, verbal proposition and real proposition. What is verbal proposition? In verbal proposition, predicates states either the whole connotation of the subject or part of connotation of the subject. Verbal proposition is that in which predicate does not give us any new information regarding subject. You know it very well. It doesn't give us any new information regarding subject. For example, all men are rational. Here the predicate rational is describing the whole connotation of the subject man, because we know the connotation of the man is animality plus rationality. The rationality is already there. So here predicate is not giving us any new information regarding subject. This is verbal proposition. Scientific induction does not establish verbal proposition. Scientific induction establishes general real proposition. So, what is real proposition? Real proposition does not merely analyze the connotation of a term, but add something new to our knowledge. It gives us new information regarding subject. For example, all men are mortal. Mortality is a new information to us, because as a connotation of term man, we know that animality is rational, animality and rationality is there, but mortality is not there. So while we are telling that all men are mortal, here the predicate mortality is adding something new to the subject man. It gives us new information regarding subject. Here the predicate mortal can put an attribute which is not a part of the connotation of the term man, because all men are mortal. Here mortality is something new attribute which is not already there in man. This type of proposition is known as real proposition, and scientific induction establishes a general real proposition. Another thing you have to know very clearly, that as induction deals with material truth, that means induction deals with formal truth as well as material truth, the question of material truth arises in relation to real proposition only. Induction deals with material truth, I repeat, and the question of material truth arises in relation to real proposition only, means that proposition which gives us new information regarding subject, because it is the real proposition which gives us new information regarding subject. So characteristics of scientific induction is that scientific induction establishes general real proposition, not particular, not verbal. Secondly, scientific induction is based on observation of facts. The general proposition established by induction are based on observation of particular instances. They are distinguished from deduction because the general proposition in case of deduction are assumed to be true, we take it for granted. But general proposition in case of induction are proved. How? General proposition in induction are derived from observation of particular instances. For example, by observing the particular instances of death of Ram, Sham, Jadu, Madhu, we arrived at the conclusion that all men are mortal. In case of deduction, we take it for granted that all men are mortal. No proof. We take it for granted all men are mortal. Ram is man. If it is the case, then Ram is mortal. But in case of induction, by observing the particular instances of death of some people, we arrived at the conclusion that all men are mortal. As induction aims at material truth, the general proposition established by induction must conform to the actual state of things. We do not take it for granted. So, the premises of induction are derived from experiences, which includes observation and experiment. So, second characteristics of scientific induction is that scientific induction is based on observation of facts. You are to observe some facts first. You are to know some facts first, and with the help of these known facts, these observed cases, you jump from some to all. Thirdly, third characteristics of scientific induction. In scientific induction, there is an inductive leap or hazard. In starting, I have said, as scientific induction belongs to the group of induction proper, so inductive leap is very much present here, because induction proper is that kind of induction where inductive leap has to be present. The most essential characteristics of induction is inductively. In induction, there is an inductive leap or hazard. Mill says, that means Mill describes induction as a process from the known to the unknown, and this process is known as inductive leap. Now, what it is? Inductive leap consists in passing from the observed cases to the unobserved cases. It is a jump from some to all, a leap in the dark. In induction, we observe particular cases, and on the basis of such observation, we make a generalization. That means there is a passing from known to unknown, observed to unobserved, or particular to general. Mill, Bain, etc. say that this is the very essence of induction. According to Mill, according to Bain, inductive leap is the essence of induction. This helps us to distinguish proper induction from the induction improperly so called. So, this is the third characteristics of induction, that in scientific induction there is an inductive leap or hazard. Last characteristics of scientific induction is that means lastly, scientific induction is based on two presuppositions. These are the law of causation and the principle of the uniformity of nature. These two principles are the postulates of induction. They are self-evident and accepted to be true without any proof. So, scientific induction is based on these two presuppositions. How and why? In my next class, I will explain these last characteristics of scientific induction and then go for unscientific induction. So, for today, let me stop here. Thank you.